Final Cut Pro has an export preset for YouTube and Facebook. Don't use it. It sucks. It makes it take way too long to export your videos. It significantly reduces the video quality. And after upload, you'll be waiting forever for your video to process on YouTube. There's a much better way to export your videos for Final Cut Pro for uploading to YouTube. Hey guys, my name is Serge, and on this channel, we try to help you make the most out of your equipment and software and tell a more engaging story by making better videos. Today, we're looking at exporting your finished project from Final Cut Pro for uploading to YouTube. I've been uploading videos to YouTube for almost 7 years now, and I've tried almost every possible preset to streamline this process as much as possible. Here's what I find works best. When you're ready to export your video, in the top right corner, hit the share button and select export file. By default, the file size of this preset is huge. I have a 4K project that's just under 6 minutes long. And with this export preset, the estimated file size is over 26 gigabytes. This is way too big. And you get an MOV file. If you go to YouTube's recommended upload settings, they recommend using an MP4 container. So back in your share window, select the settings tab, and from the format drop-down menu, select one of the publishing formats. For the best quality possible, select the computer preset, change your video codec to H.264 better quality, and choose a resolution for your video. With this preset, your video exports in an MP4 container, and the estimated file size is over 10 times smaller, dropping from 26 gigabytes to just over 2. And that's just the estimated file size. This exact video file, after export, turned out to be only 1.9 gigabytes. Now, the good part is, you don't have to go through all these steps every time you export a video. You can make your own custom preset with these exact settings. Go to Final Cut Pro's Preferences, and in the Destinations tab, grab the Export File preset, and drag this over to your destination sidebar. Rename this preset to make it easier to find. On the right-hand side, change the format to Computer, Video Codec to H.264 better quality, and select the highest resolution available. This is the resolution limit, so if you're exporting an HD project, your exported resolution will be the same as your project. If you use Final Cut Pro mainly to edit your YouTube videos, I'd also recommend making this your default export preset. Just right-click on your new preset and select Make Default. Also, if you have the YouTube and Facebook preset in your sidebar, right-click on it and delete this garbage. Close your preferences window. Now, when you hit the export button, you should see your new preset as one of the share options. And since this is your default preset, you don't even have to do this much. Once your project is finished, all you have to do is use the keyboard shortcut Command E to export your project in this new preset. And if we select the settings tab in our export window, as you can see, everything is set just the way we need it to be. Now, there is one more preset I use, especially when traveling or if my internet connection is extra slow. To get the smallest size possible while retaining the best video quality, I find that Apple Devices 4K preset works really good. This compresses your video file using the new HEVC codec, and the video file size of the exact same project as before is almost 4 times smaller, only 664 megabytes for a 6-minute 4K video. With this preset, you get an M4V file, which is basically Apple's version of MP4, and in my experience, YouTube can process these file types almost as fast as MP4s. If you want to learn more about making YouTube videos in Final Cut Pro, I put together a short playlist to help you optimize your videos for best engagement. Click here to watch it.